Here are some important thoughts and questions you should have in your mind before you go out and bring home your new dog. First off, I will pull no punches in this regard of owning a new dog. It is a lot of work at first. Here is an example. Every time the new pup wakes up from a nap, he or she will need to go pee and off you go outside. This new dog will be with you for the next 10 to 15 years at least. Also, this new dog can and will be a loyal, faithful and devoted companion. Bringing a dog into your home is an important step for you and your family. There are many breeds to choose from. How do you manage to make a decision on which one breed is best suited for you? With a little thought, you can nail down the selections and find the best suited dog breed by following a few simple steps. Foremost, how much space do you have? Ask yourself how much space do you have in your home? It should be the primary factor to consider before picking the dog breed. If you and your family live in a tiny apartment, you will want to refrain from getting a large dog. Look for dogs in the toy group, such as Yorkshire Terriers, or some of the smaller dogs in the terrier group, like the miniature Schnauzer. With that said, if you have children, you have to think about the size of the dog, as well. Very small dogs, such as Chihuahuas or Maltese, can be very frail and are occasionally accidentally injured by very tiny children. But then, very prominent dogs, such as Boxers or the Saint Bernard, can be overly rumbustious as puppies and can inadvertently turn your infant into a human bowling pin. Consider average-sized breeds, such as Fox Terriers or Lhasa Apso, as an alternative. The next thing is, can you give your new dog any exercise? If you have a residence with a fenced yard, your domestic dog will be able to get some physical exercise on his own. But, dog breeds in the sporting, hound, and herding groupings are very high-energy animals and you will need to have enough time to provide them with more intensive physical exercise. Plan to take a great deal of long strolls with your new hound or go for a day-after-day romp in the park. Let's think about it. These new dog breeds were bred to work hard and don't do well unless they have a job to do or a way to burn off excess energy. Finally, don't forget to look at grooming demands. Some domestic dog breeds only need a little more than a half hour or so of grooming a week, while others call for to be groomed for around a little more than an hour a day. So let's think about it. If you are short on time, don't buy a poodle or a Maltese, unless, of course, you plan to take your new hound for a groom. Breeds like Boston Terriers or Whippets are fine choices for busy people who don't have time to do a lot of grooming. Boiled down, the best dog breed is the one that fits the kind of life the future owner has. Lastly, most people choose their dog breed because each person has their own preconceived idea of what he or she wants in a dog. Sometimes it's just the physical attributes of the dog, like the size, the shape of the face or the overall looks. Do yourself a favor and do not forget the above simple steps. After you make up your mind on which breed of new puppy you want, you will need to consider the age of the new puppy. Many individuals opt to buy a cuddly little puppy instead of an older new hound. While puppies have not acquired any bad habits, it will be up to the new owner to be sure that the puppy becomes housebroken and obedience trained. Whilst you've specified the breed options and have determined which new dog is right for you, don't get too relaxed. After all, you still have a single more important choice to make, what to name your new puppy. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and feel free to subscribe for more videos.